Hello everyone, Investrans Research is back again. These days there's a lot of buzz in the market about GST, that GST is coming out. A lot of analysts has been talking on the news channels that GST is rolling out. So what exactly is GST? So Investrans Research thought of breaking down because we have been getting a lot of queries that what is GST and how it's going to impact. So let's see what is GST. So GST is nothing but goods and service taxes in India. So it's not an additional tax, it's just the parent tax, because there are a lot of taxes that is implemented: excise, entertainment tax, VAT. I'll go to the tax structure of India, but at this point of time, GST is the parent of all taxes, so you don't need to pay different taxes. So there's one thing: just pay GST and get out, get your stuff out of the factory or get your services done. So this GST is already present in many countries, including Pakistan has also GST implemented in them. So its main motive is to bring all the taxes under one bracket. So for all the goods and services, all the imports, can't say all the imports, but it has also categorized some goods, because customs will be there, and after that whatever goods are coming, it depends on the list what government has given, it will be coming under GST or not. Okay, so after a lot of around 100 plus amendments in the constitution, finally to 1st July 2017 has been proposed as a date for rollout of GST. If there will be a lot of opposition and people opposing the GST rollout, September is the time that GST has to be implemented in India. There's no delay in that. But I don't see, or we don't see in India these days, for any opposition for GST, because it's a good thing. So there are different rates for GST, like 5%, 12%, 18%, and 28%. There are four rates for GST. 5% will be used for common items, very small and common items that are being used will be coming under GST for that. 12 to 18% will be the maximum contributor for the GST, because it's a standard rate for all the goods and services that are being produced in India. And within state, interstate, whatever is there, much of the contribution will be 12 to 18%. 28% will be for the luxury items, the big cars and big brands and everything, all the luxury, whatever is categorized under luxurious items, will be charging 28% for them. And few items which will not be charged under GST will be alcohol. Alcohol will still be having the state and VAT taxes. Electricity will again be under state duty only. And tobacco is a product which is always being taxed, you can say excise, and plus the GST will be added to that tobacco. So it is like they are not removing excise and just implementing GST. It will be excise plus GST to tobacco. And real estate will be still having the stamp duty on it, and it will be out of GST bracket. So cheers to that. And this is the current tax structure in India. Like India, current before first of July, you can say that tax structure is direct tax. There's an indirect tax. Direct tax is what we pay, the employees in paying income tax, the wealth tax, the wealth we have. And the indirect tax is whatever the manufacturers and all the goods and services we use. We go to the restaurant, we watch movies, we buy cars, we take some services. So these taxes are categorized as indirect taxes. So as you can see, that the central tax and the state tax, central tax is a tax which goes to the central government, state tax is a tax which goes to the state governments. So central taxes charge like excise, service tax, customs, and state taxes like VAT, entry, luxury. So all this will be categorized under a GST. So all the indirect taxes. So the plan of the government is like, give us the money under GST and we will distribute it to the state, we'll distribute it to the central government. So that's the plan. So this is the proposed structure of GST tax structure, you can say. So there are direct tax, no impact to that. and like indirect tax, which will be GST, like which will be converted into GST. As I said, the imports except customs is because, as I said, customs will be charged, and other than that, whatever goods you are importing to India, the goods will be charged and taxed likewise. So GST is basically categorized into an intrastate and interstate levels of supplies of goods and services, you can say. So if it is like intrastate, it will be like CGST and SGST, which is a state GST. CGST is central GST. And if it is like interstate, I'll come to an example for that. If it is an interstate, it will be like IGST, which is completely central. So IGST certainly comprises of CGST and SGST. It is not like things are quite costlier for interstate, and it is a combination of CGST plus SGST, so it is quite heavily taxed. So subsuming the existing taxes here, you can see that the CGST is central GST. It is applicable to supply within the state. The tax revenue which will be gathered, which will be collected, will be shared to the center. Okay, because the center poses some taxes to the manufacturer that you have to give this money to center, and then if you want, you can give it to not if you want, if the state wants, they can charge on them, but the center is applying that you have to give the money to us. So it is like CGST is based on the revenues of the center. So all the excise, central sales tax, and service taxes will be coming under CGST bracket, right? And similarly, SGST is the state GST, and it is also for the supplies within the state. The taxes which will be collected will be totally going to the state government, so it will also be replacing the taxes like VAT, entertainment tax, luxury lottery, and other stamp duties and goods based on whichever the state government were charging on the manufacturers and the service provider. So it will be coming under so SGST bracket. So, and other than that, there's IGST, there's the integrated GST, which is totally based on the supplies that is being supplied to interstate, like not within the state but interstate to different states, and also the imports. So and the taxes which will be collected will be given to the center and as well as state, right? Okay, just giving you an example for that. Like if it is an intrastate supplies, it will be like if the supplies are being transferred from Maharashtra to Maharashtra, it will be CGST and SGST, like central GST and the state GST taxes. And if the supplies are from Maharashtra to Uttar Pradesh, which combines of two different state and refers to interstate transfers or interstate transfers of goods and services, so it refers to IGST, like integrated GST. So your main motive is to just to see that lot of taxes that you were paying, that excise whenever you were going to a restaurant and paying bills, and you can see paying excise, VAT, or other stuff, it will be combined and you'll be getting just CGST applied or SGST applied or IGST applied to that. And you need to just all the revenue, the benefits of this will be like you don't need to, the manufacturers and the service providers doesn't really need to pay so many taxes in a different way or different format. You just need to pay GST, and the center will be distributing this revenue among the state and the central government. So its impact on the markets, it's a good move by the government because it was pending since long, so very long, and a lot of other countries have implemented, but India is implementing it too late. So benefits to the manufacturers, ease of business, it will improve the logistics, improve the infrastructure of India, and other benefits, because all the people who were just giving taxes to the state or small vendors and other things will be coming under GST now, because government has also given a list of goods and services that will be categorized under GST. You can always go and Google and see that. So I hope I have given a layman or better understanding of GST now. Still, if you have any queries on GST, please do comment on this YouTube video. I'll be answering that question. And also, you can like our Facebook page, Investrance Research, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you have any queries, please write down to us on investranceresearch@gmail.com. And thank you. This was from Investrance Research, making investment decisions better. Thank you.